Hello everyone. Today I'm going to, in this series of healing to wholeness, I'm going to talk about a very important topic called as trauma. And why do I say that this is an important topic? The reason is that many of our health issues arise out of some events that has happened in the past, which the body has not been able to resolve. We call such events as trauma. Trauma, and we will talk more about what trauma really means and how do we heal it. But many a times, many of our chronic illnesses, cough, cold, acidity, body pain, and much more severe chronic illnesses arise out of some experience which is stored or frozen in the body, and we haven't healed it or we don't even remember it, but it keeps playing out, and when that energy cannot be released by the body, it turns into illness. And that is why even when you are connected, when you start connecting to the body, deeper connection to the body, or you get into some kind of a yoga regime where the process is slow, many a times people experience symptoms they can make no sense of. That is because the body is releasing trauma. And therefore, an important component is for you to understand what exactly is trauma and how do we see it. I know that trauma is considered to be a very heavy word, and therefore many people don't want to talk about it. But it is important, and therefore I would like to explain to you what really is trauma. Trauma is a loss of connection to ourselves, our bodies, to others, and to the world around. When our body, when the systems in the body are moving rhythmically, for example, your heartbeats are at the pace at which they are supposed to be, your breathing is regulated. When you are relaxed and calm and composed, is when you can really make connection with the world, when you can really enjoy things around. Now, yes, our lives are not black and white, so sometimes we are able to make some connection. But if you really want to deepen your connection, then trauma in your body needs to be released. Trauma can occur by normal everyday events. And what I mean by that is you're going on a bicycle somewhere and you fall down. What the body experiences, what the nervous system experiences, is a threat. Something abnormal has happened. It probably also experiences pain. So then the nervous system tries to do something about it. But because we are also highly rational, intelligent beings, if we quickly get up from the ground and quickly begin to move, that part of the body does not realize that the danger is over. And therefore, the trauma remains locked up. Years later, you might suddenly start experiencing fear of falling down. You might suddenly start experiencing imbalance in your body, and you wouldn't know what really happened. It was what had happened years ago was a simple normal bicycle accident which all of us have gone through. I'm sure any of us who learned bicycle have fallen at some point, but because it has stayed in your body, it is going to inform something later on whenever it comes up. And therefore, trauma is in the body and not in the event. So if something very big has happened, but you have been able to move through it, body has experienced safety, it will not get stored as trauma. Whereas something as simple as falling off a bicycle, or even falling while walking or running or stumbling, can become a trauma. Trauma is about the nervous system. As I have said before, our autonomous nervous system is responsible for making sure that we are safe, that we survive. And therefore, any experience of threat, and we will experience the nervous system becoming ready to fight or to run away. And when it is not able to do either, it does not experience safety and therefore will continue. And as I said before, symptoms can occur years later. So there are three types of trauma. There are traumas which are natural disasters, war zone, man-made disasters, sexual assaults, terrorism, violence and so on, which are big traumas. They have a bigger impact and they actually can be caught at the time of the trauma. Then there are smaller traumas, car accidents, surgeries, dog bites, where the body, we are going into the surgery to save our own lives. We are going into surgery to heal something. But for the body, for the autonomous nervous system, it has sensed something which is not normal. It has experienced being cut, being anesthetized, being numbed. And therefore, that can also stay as a trauma in your body. And then there are these small C traumas, as they are called, domestic violence, poverty, which are more racism, which are more collective in nature. When we experience traumas, if we are not paid attention to the body or at that moment or later, then these traumas can play out in various different ways, as anxiety, as depression, as body ache, as falling down, as cough, cold, as small illnesses which keep occurring again and again, and sometimes may occur as big diseases because the immune system broke down. So once when we understand trauma, these are some of the symptoms that you can look at, but there can be many more. So once when we understand trauma, how do we heal it? Well, as I have shared before, we heal it by getting the body to feel safe. And how do we get it to feel safe? So coming back to how trauma affects body. So when something happens, say we experience some kind of violence, we get into a fight mode. Anger comes up, our fists tighten, our jaws tighten. When we are not able to fight, we decide to run away. When we are not able to do that, we freeze. And because we have intelligence, rational intelligence, we sometimes ignore the freeze and we submit or we move on. But the body has played dead for some time in that part and it has not shaken up the locked up energy. So how do we release trauma? We release trauma by shaking up the locked up energy. So for example, a memory comes up where somebody insulted you, somebody was not good to you, somebody violated something about you. As you remember the incidents, your body will tighten. Your fists will come up, your hands will come up, and your hands will try to push, or your jaws will tighten. Allow your body to do that in slow motion. For bigger traumas, reach out to somebody who can help you release it from your system. Because the body needs to feel safe, you need to have a container around you who can help you release trauma. So trauma is an important component, and when it comes up, maybe through flashes of memory or maybe suddenly realizing a body movement, pay attention and help yourself heal. That's all for today. We can talk more about this. I've spoken more about this previously also. Please feel free to write to me at sanjyotp@gmail.com. And we can connect. Thank you very much.
Help Talks are daily health-related talks held at Health Education Library for People, Mumbai, India. For more information, visit www.healthlibrary.com. Subscribe to Help Talks channel. Be better informed about your health.